Welcome to Boracay, or the island next to Boracay. We have just arrived and we are very excited. There's an actual swamp. Spent the last week and a half in Siargal surfing, chilling, drinking, eating, all the kind of jazz. And then we've flown this morning at 4:30 in the morning here to Boracay, or the island next to Boracay. So the plan is to get there as soon as possible so we can go check it out, which starts with baggage claim. Here's the conveyor belt.
Oh, is that baggage claim?
That is literally baggage claim.
There you go.
Oh yeah. Excuse me.
Oh, that's mine.
Yours is there, Gaz. Thank you. The most unconventional baggage claim I have ever seen.
If anything, it's easier, isn't it?
Yeah, it's an easy bag, but anyone can take it. Anyway, let's go find out how we get there then, shall we?
Yeah.
Boracay?
Oh look, van over there. Oh, I'm not doing 1,050.
So 200, 100 per person to get a van to the quarry core. I'm thinking that's the cheapest way rather than doing the package. Well, you can get a tricycle for 75 pesos, but we'd rather get a van.
What's on my shirt? Oh. So they're trying to charge 1,050 pesos per person to get a bus, a ferry, and then a taxi to our hotel. But that seems really, really steep, to be honest, so.
We decided to do the journey ourselves in the hope that it would be cheaper, as we didn't actually have that in cash. It was almost the same price as our flight from Cebu to Boracay.
We're here at the port, now we've got to work out the logistics here. We need to go here.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Here?
No. The table.
Okay. What do we need to do?
Fill a form out.
Ah, okay.
They literally made us fill in the old bit of paper and then was like, well, that's 800 each. Write down your hotel. Do you know what I mean?
You can literally pay half the price.
So we wasted 20 minutes writing all of our information down and then decided not to go with the package and navigate it ourselves again.
Step one, tourist registration and verification counter. Here we go. Step one. This is chaos. This is the most chaos we've actually had to deal with coming into anywhere.
It's starting to annoy me.
Yeah, okay.
I'm so tired after our 4 a.m. get up. I wish people would just be a bit more honest.
Yeah, I know, same.
And like, hello.
Hello.
For how many persons?
For two, please.
Right. Wish me luck.
So Steph, we registered there, now he's going to here to get a ticket. And if you're confused by all of that, so are we, but just come inside, guys. Don't go to the desks outside. If you want to do it cheaper, obviously, if you want to pay more and get like an easy route, then go for the expensive ones outside. But I wish people had said that to us when we stood there and filled out all the documents, and then they're like, anyway, positive thoughts, we're going to Boracay. It's going to be good.
That was 400 pesos per person, environmental and terminal fee. The biggest one we've paid so far in the Philippines. And genuinely, I'm a bit concerned because we've only got 600 cash left.
Oh yeah, how much is the boat?
I don't know.
Well, we'll have to work it out. No? Hi.
Where can we buy the boat? Yeah, we pay there, yeah. Boat ticket that way?
50 pesos only.
50 pesos.
Oh, amazing.
Cool.
Yes. Are
you boat is only 50 pesos, apparently. So that's actually really cheap.
Yeah, so I think it is a lot cheaper to do it yourself.
Here we go.
Boat ticket here. 50. We might actually have enough pesos, I'm not sure.
It'd be a miracle if we do.
Yeah, but... two, please.
Hey, what's happening now?
You then gave that personal information slip, plus the boat ticket you just bought, and exchange it for a laminated boat number.
Yeah?
Is that? Oh, God. Thank you. We've got our tickets.
Oh, thank you.
Sorry. You're in the corner there.
So you even have seat numbers that you have to adhere to on this boat, which is very...
I'm miles away, look.
Yeah, Gaz is over here.
57's not next to 58.
Okay. Here we are, touchdown on Boracay sand. Now we need to get a tricycle to our hotel. I'm so hot and bothered. I want to feel the happiness when we arrive.
I know,
properly.
Once our bags are dumped. I mean, I have never been, well actually, I tell a lie, I have got off a boat onto a beach before, but it's quite weird how there's actually no port. You just kind of like rock up to the beach and jump on it.
Yeah.
We're on a really nice beach now. We're going to the Piccolo. Yeah. How much? 150, okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh my God, hang on.
What?
It's an electric tricycle.
Yeah, e-trike.
It's so quiet, isn't it?
Yeah, I think they're trying to do it for the environment.
That's
yeah.
so good.
Since it reopened.
I was actually like, where's the loud engine? You can speak.
So you would think, wouldn't you, that going to like the desk where you jump in a transfer, a shared van, you'd think that would be cheaper, right? But oh no, they want it to charge us 400. But this lovely gentleman here is doing a tricycle for 150, which is what we was expecting to pay, so we didn't even bother haggling with it.
So in total, what did we spend? That's
so
interesting, I think.
100 on the bus to the port, 400 environmental fee, 50 pesos for the boat, 150 for this. So quick maths, 1,250 pesos, which is 625 pesos each, which is about 500 pesos cheaper than what they originally tried to charge us. So
yeah.
I consider that a win.
We win. Even though we're hot.
Even though we've stressed and we've had about four arguments with each other.
But anyway, it's exciting, isn't it? To our hotel.
I'll be excited. Should we get in the pool?
I need to cool down for sure. There's sidewalks. There's pavements. Oh, that is unheard of in anywhere in the Philippines. So that's pretty forward and developed. Thank you.
Down there, yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Down here? Oh my God, it's flooded.
What is your
name? Piccolo.
Yes, Piccolo.
Ah, oh, that way.
What the hell is this?
A river. Do we have a boat?
Yeah, do we have a boat? Oh my God, there's an actual swamp. This is disgusting.
That's why our hotel's so cheap.
I have no idea. I did see a review on this one actually, but I was like, oh, how bad could it be?
What did it say?
That there's a massive river and you have to like wade through it to get to the hotel.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did. It's on TripAdvisor.
Are you joking?
No. But I've always thought a bit of water never hurt us, did it? As long as it's not toilet water.
We're going to have to walk through it.
It's disgusting. Here?
No. Or is it this one?
Hello.
I've got a booking. Gareth. Gareth Davies. Yeah.
What's happened to the street?
Yeah, when it rains from it floods outside because of all the drainage.
Oh, okay.
It needs to be fixed by the local government.
Okay. Thank you.
Also outside tomorrow if it won't rain.
Ah.
Okay.
Thanks. Okay, so we've had a little bit of time to sleep essentially since we got up at 4 a.m. and now we're excited to go in, check out White Beach
and watch the sunset. So I have a slight confession to make. I've been here 8 years ago. I came here when I was 20 years old with my three girlfriends and it's Gaz's first time. So right now we're capturing my second opinion of this place, which was before I came, before it all got renovated, and at Gaz's actual first impressions. But straight away when we walked on the beach, there is literally...
How is it so busy?
So...
I don't know how it's so busy.
Yeah, it is actually very, very busy.
Abby's live music radar's going off. She was like, oh, I hear a guitar, I hear live music. So we're heading that way. Thank you. Cheers.
Yeah.
Thank you.
We have buy one, take one.
Yes.
Sorry, Captain. Our signature cup in the
amaretto style.
Okay.
Thank you. So we're actually at Smooth Cafe that we went to in Melbourne. We had a really, really good time. It's slightly more expensive here though, but only a little bit. But this seems to be the best cafe in terms of seating arrangement and vibe. So we're gonna sample the menu, so to speak.
Amaretto sours, which I probably have had in the past, but I don't remember it, and it's buy one get one free, which is why I got them. It literally tastes like Christmas.
It's Christmas here already.
Yeah, it is. It's like marzipan galore. Do you know what I mean? Do you reckon they eat marzipan here for Christmas? Do you reckon they eat Christmas cake? Let me know in the comments. Do you eat Christmas cake at Christmas? I don't, because I don't like it.
I'd say not.
Well, you don't think so?
No.
You think I say a British Christmas thing?
Yeah.
I'll pop up a pitch here as well. But if you do, let me know. That's interesting. But yeah, tastes like marzipan. So there's definitely a huge storm coming in. I don't know if you can see, but like, it's not just going dark from the sun going down.
The camera makes it lighter than it is.
It's so black in the distance, so we might get trapped somewhere. It's going to chuck it down, I can tell.
Start is absolutely tipping it down now, so everybody's ran inside. A nice little bit of jazz music going on and a few beers, so I like watching storms from not in the storm.
Yeah.
We then headed to an Italian along the beach to end our first day. I think a lack of sleep was really weighing us down and dulling our usual excitement for a new destination. We were desperate to get to bed and wake up with a fresh head and hopefully a brighter perspective on Boracay.
Alright guys, today is a new day. Obviously we were not in the best of moods yesterday, running off 3 hours sleep, but we've got up this morning, I've gone to the gym, Gaz has gone and done martial arts training, and we're feeling so much better, literally clear head, feeling good. So anyway, we've gone out for some lunch today. It is actually a work day for us, but we wanted to get some proper first impressions where we're not being miserable bastards today. So we've headed to Lemon Cafe. I'll put the name on the screen to get some lunch, and we'll have a wander around and show you Boracay in the day. So this cafe is actually in quite a good spot. It's in the middle of the D Mall, which means there's people walking past on either direction, so it's great for people watching. But yeah, it's a beautiful venue as well, and like really beautiful design. You can tell there's a lot more money here than there is, and it's probably the busiest place I've been to in the whole of the Philippines. It feels like we're in like Spain or something, you know, like in the height of summer.
There's a sailing race going on. Look.
Oh yeah.
It's definitely not. It's definitely not just like tourist boats. Look, they've got little flags on the top. That's got a Swiss flag.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. It looks like there's a sailing competition going on. But the difference between day and night, and obviously when it was thundering it down last night, is crazy. It's absolutely beautiful at the moment.
Yeah. And there's barely anyone on the beach because obviously people like to come and like when it's not, the sun is.
Everyone
not...
comes for sunset for their photos, don't they?
Yeah. But oh my god, I'm definitely going to be doing some sunbathing here. Oh, it's stunning. It really is. There's palm trees lining the beach, massive stretch of sand as well. And the water looks fun to play in because it's got some waves. So yeah, feeling much better today, I have to say. Just your outlook on life feels a thousand times better when you've had some sleep and you've exercised.
Yeah, you're always going to be annoyed when you wake up at 4 a.m. and traipse around the whole morning.
Yeah, and you're just grumpy as hell. So we apologise for that, guys, but we want to keep it real on this channel. So if we're being grumpy, sometimes we'll show it. Most of the time we won't, but sometimes we will. Okay, so we are actually heading to a friend's hostel to go and book onto an island hopping tour for tomorrow, so that'll be super exciting. We've got two other videos planned here where we're going to really explore Boracay, so make sure you hit the subscribe button for that one and give us a thumbs up if you like this video. And yeah, we'll see the rest of Boracay tomorrow. Bye!